Long since you've been on video with me. Hey everyone, welcome back. It's been quite a busy day. I think this is number 4 adoption today.
Wow.
We have Josie in the house. Josie has found her forever mama. And I love Jody.
We love you too.
I spent a lot of time at Jody's house. I love her. She's perfect for Josie.
I felt the same.
And I told you, I said, she is going to have the best life with Jody. Yep. No question about it. She
I knew
gets
when
it.
They left her.
She gets
very
it.
Love.
Yes.
Yeah. Very loved little girl.
So we're here doing the official adoption. For any of you that are looking at this beautiful girl who's all clean and groomed, this is not what she looked like when we took her in. I received a call on our hotline. It was late in the day. The hospital was closing. The woman, basically the phone call went like this. Do you all take in dogs? And I said, well, ma'am, what's going on? There's a dog that's been outside my yard for a month. She's completely matted. I said, have you fed her, given her water? She said, no, I don't like animals. It was raining. I knew immediately we needed to go. She sent me a photo. I couldn't believe what I saw. This tiny little white, completely matted. Couldn't even see her face. We didn't even know if she was a male or a female when we picked her up. We couldn't feel back there because she was so neglected and matted. She had a flea collar around her neck that was so tight I could barely get my finger in between her neck and the flea collar. Cut that right off. Made an appointment for the following day to get her groomed by Michael. He did a beautiful job. And then our wonderful Gail. Talk about taking a village to save one life. Gail over here, who has fostered countless dogs for 100 plus. Thank you.
Oh, awesome.
Thank you. Josie has been in her home and being loved and spoiled, and she's for a street dog, she's spoiled brat. She needs chicken. She demands, but you've got her down to food now, right?
We slowly weaned that away to give Jody a little break. But yeah, she's doing the dog food now, so she's doing dog food, anything she gets.
She's a baby. She's a young girl. Yeah. She's beautiful. She does have a small cherry eye. I assured Jody that I called the doctor while I was at Jody's home so Jody could have her mind at ease, and Dr. Carrastro in Deerfield, so we'll set up an appointment, and we'll have that looked at, and whatever it is, Jody agreed that we would split the cost. It wasn't much. What was it, like $500 or something like that? So we will take care of whatever this angel needs. Right, Josie?
Hi. You remember me, don't you, Josie? Yes, you do. Yes, she's so happy.
She's such a sweet dog with so much love inside of her. She just wants a person. She really loves to cuddle, right?
Yeah,
she loves her bed.
My type of dog.
Yeah, she doesn't require another dog.
She's heavy on the lap. She's on your lap.
Oh, you made it.
I
didn't get to meet you at the house.
Hi,
what's your name?
Hi,
Sydney. Oh, and I heard Josie fell.
She
jumped the baby gate to get to you, Sydney.
Yes, I know. Hi.
This is magical. Magical. I went to their home. Your home is beautiful, Sydney.
Thank you.
Beautiful home.
We're so excited.
So much love and safe in a fenced yard, and it's just perfect. It's so perfect.
We went toy shopping.
You did. See, guys.
Oh, I have her bed in the car.
We'll get it on the way out. This is exactly what it's all about. I received hundreds, I'm not kidding you, hundreds of emails for people that wanted Josie. It just wasn't the fit. It wasn't right. And everyone kept saying to me, Amy, what's taking so long? You know, what's taking so long? I'm like, I'm not rescuing these dogs. Just give them to anybody. It has to be perfect. And, you know, granted, it holds up a space where Gail could take in another, but I want the best for our dogs. Best. And I spent how much? I was at your house for quite some time, right?
Yeah,
we had a night, almost an hour, and that's what we do. I go over the entire, you know, safety and...
We all bonded.
We had bonding time. So, guys, this is my happy time. This is the reward of taking in a dog that's been abandoned, neglected. Dr. Clark, thank you so much for taking such good care of her medically. Can't even see an incision. He spayed her and did all her vaccines and microchip and all that good stuff. So she's healthy and beautiful, and she's ready. Are you ready to start your new journey, huh, Josie? Are you? Come here. So you never, ever, ever see anything bad ever again in your entire life, Josie.
No.
Only good from here on out.
Yeah.
You've got Sydney who's going to cuddle with you and love you, and Mommy Jody and a daddy at home and a brother.
Waiting for you.
Everybody's waiting. Your husband didn't meet her yet.
No, I asked everyone to come. He said, well, you know, I just think it might be a lot for her. I think when she comes home, we just need to make sure that, she, you know, it's we can calm her, make sure she feels settled. And I said, you go home, you make her a sign. Welcome home, Josie.
It's good stuff, Josie.
So he's excited for her.
And you'll definitely keep me posted and text me and let me know how things are going.
It's mandatory.
It's not a problem.
And, it's a requirement.
And mom's going away, so you're responsible. Yes. So you're going to take care of her. Did you guys think about getting that baby gate yet?
Actually, someone that I work with has gates. He said, don't go buy one.
I'll give it to you. Yes. Perfect. Yes, just the door, saying. Because she's new and, you know, she's quick.
She's a jumping bean.
And she's a jumping bean.
It's
so.
She's like a
kangaroo. And especially, we have to watch out if there's cats in the neighborhood, apparently.
Yeah, did you see her going?
Yeah, I mean, I don't know if she's ever seen, you know, who knows what she what she saw. I don't have any, so I think it was new to her, the smell.
I just want to tell you, wait, if you do let her hair grow in, it is going to be so magnificent.
Oh, oh my goodness.
Can you imagine?
It's really hard because when these dogs come in so matted and they just shave them down, we don't really know.
It's soft as silk.
I know. She's gorgeous now, but it's when her coat grows in, that full face, you know, she's just so beautiful. It's good stuff. Thank you. I want to say thank you to my wife, Carol, who jumped in her car in the rain and ran to get Josie.
Thank you, Carol.
It wasn't easy. Let me tell you, when she got there, she growled at Carol, and she slipped through the chain link fence, and Carol was finally able to get her. Then after that, it was smooth sailing. She jumped in the car, and she was kissing Carol's face off. So, you know, she's got a little, this girl's got a little attitude, don't you? Good stuff. Everybody, this is our happy gotcha day,
happy adoption day
for Josie. I love you, Mommy. Oh. You're going to have the best life. I know it. Yes, you are.
Oh,
the best.
Thank you.
You're welcome, Josie.
Thank you.
This is a happy, happy day. Thank you both so much. And Gail, 100 plus abandoned dogs of Everglades, Florida. Josie is home.
Yay.